Hey there, Nigel here again. So this is part two for Secrets for a Successful Business. So like I shared earlier, some of my friends and family and people asked me, Nigel, what's your secret sauce to hustle from, you know, like from $100 in your pocket all the way to like a four-figure business, then a five-figure business, then six-figure business, then acquired at seven figures plus, you know? And after I finished my moratorium, I took an 18-month sabbatical, whereas my wife started a business. 18 months sabbatical was great, and then I spent lots of time with kids and my family, reading and praying as well. And then after I finished my sabbatical, my wife asked me to come and help her, and then I went to the business to help her. It's called Phoenix Rehab Physio, and I grew the business 200% plus in the last about 1 year, 2 years ish. I was there and grown quite a lot, and we're still growing. Right now we're very close to the 7-figure mark, and we're gonna expand year on year as well. So. That was important for me, because if you've done that once, you can do it again. But when you do it twice, you're like, fuck, I know this shit, right? So part one, the 3 points in part one I shared earlier is that you got to know your products and your services, right? You got to know the inside out of your products and services. You got to know the benefits that it brings. By knowing this, it's easier for you to communicate the benefits to your leads, your prospects, your clients. So it's easier for you to sell and close, okay? It's not just about closing for the sake of closing. It's also a lot about being clearly communicating what you can do so that your clients and prospects can make a decision. So no, you got to know your products and services. In as much as you got to know your products and services, second point in part one was you got to be on top of business. Yeah, you know, some people, what they do is that they get too entrenched. They're too stuck in the doing. Unless you're happy just doing, it's fine. Some people are meant to be just doers, and it's okay. The world is big enough. There's more than enough abundance for everyone. So if you are choosing to be a doer in the business because you like it, go for it. However, if you want to scale your business, you want to grow your business, you want to delegate more, you got to go get on top of business. We can look down on your business. Don't look down on it like a bad way, but it's more like study your business, study the processes, study the flow, study the touch points, the break points. You got to be on top of a business to know how to expand it, refine, grow it. And number three, Warren Buffett's famous quote was like, to delight your clients, to delight your customers by spending time with them, being sincere with them. You know, you screw up, admit it, and take care of them and make it up to them. You know, treat them like your family. Be sincere. Don't just treat them like cash cows, right? So that was part one. 3 points. Now we're talking about part two. I only have 6 points for my secret sauce for a successful business. Number four, you got to keep improving, keep working hard. You know, hard work helps you to get bloody fucking good at what you do. And you got to be damn good at what you do. There is a difference. Hard work helps you to reach more clients. You know, as you get better, as you work harder, work more, you know, you get more clients and you get to expand your business more. Hard work will get you to where you want to be. So there's no substitute for hard work. I can't outsource my push-ups. I can't outsource my diet. Fuck. If I could, I would. But there's no substitute. You got to put in the work. You know, you got to keep progressing, punching and moving forward. Okay, just keep on doing that. Number five, you got to simplify. One of the mistakes that many entrepreneurs, many business owners take is that they are all things at all time. Okay, I'll give you an example, right? So what do you think if you compare a cake shop that sells all sorts of cakes to a chocolate cake shop that sells chocolate cakes? Can you tell the difference? So when you want a cake, where will you go? Maybe if you're the sort of person who likes a lot of variety, you might go to the cake shop. But I tell you, If I were to choose to open a cake shop, I won't do a generic cake shop. I will do a cake shop with a niche. It could be a chocolate cake shop with just 3 types of chocolate cakes. Maybe just a simple plain chocolate cake, the good old chocolate cake, maybe a chocolate cake with maybe what, black forest and something else. By having very streamlined products, it makes it easier for clients to decide. If I want a cake, and I go to a cake shop, I got to choose between 30 cakes, 10, 20, 30 cakes, or if not, why not I just go to this cake, this chocolate cake shop and just choose out of three cakes? It's so easy for clients to make a decision. So simplify, do one thing at a time. And also by doing one thing at a time, you get really good at one thing rather than being like a jack of all trades. Niching down is always more powerful than being jack of all trades, no matter how you look at it. It's like when Gordon Ramsay, he goes into any restaurants, you know, he will look at the menu and he'll like, what the fuck? You got 50 items in your menu. Simplify it. Do just two starters, three mains, and, you know, two desserts, and you're done. So just simplify makes it very easy for you, for the client to make the decision, very easy for you from a logistical and operational standpoint. And it just takes off your mental load. Juggling 5 items is easier than juggling 50 items anytime. Okay? So simplify one core pillar at a time. Master one, add on another one. Okay? And number 6, this is one of the most important ones because entrepreneurship is really big part of it is mind. There's a lot of it is mind and patience. You see, you gotta persist. You don't give up because success takes time. Nobody will have success overnight. There is no such thing. Getting good takes practice. Mistakes takes time. Overcoming tough times takes time. Sometimes you may need to persist through fucking assholes, betrayers, traitors. You know, criticisms too. That happens. Sometimes you get good days, but sometimes you get shit days. Sometimes you get tired. Sometimes you get heartbroken. Sometimes you get happy. Sometimes you get sad, right? Sometimes what you started off with, or you envisioned with, in, may not be what you end up with, you know? You gotta learn from your mistakes, learn from your observations, you know, learn from your pain, learn from the lessons, right? And use it to get better. You know, you just keep getting better. The name of the game is have fun learning, applying, growing, getting better, right? And that's really it. That's my six secrets, my secret sauce. A quick overview: know your products and your services inside out so that you can communicate better to your clients. Number 2, be on top of business so you can study what works, what doesn't work for your business and improve the processes. Number 3, you got to know and delight your clients, your customers. Spend time with them, talk to them, treat them sincerely. Don't treat them like cash cows or ATMs, right? If you screw up, say sorry and make it up to them. Treat them like your family, okay? Don't leave them hanging. Number 4, work hard, keep improving. There's no substitute for hard work. Hard work cannot be delegated. I can't, like I said, I can't delegate my push-ups. I can't delegate my diets. If I could, I would. You got to keep moving forward. Number 5, simplify. Do one thing very well at a time. Don't provide 20, 50 products at one time. If you cannot be, you cannot know them inside out and be specialized in it, I'd rather you focus on 3. Be damn good in 3. Lastly, you got to push through, you got to persist through the pain, through betrayals, through tiredness, through mental health challenges, through the mistakes you learn, and through sometimes you just meet wrong people. But push through until you meet the right people, until you get to where you want to go. Like Les Brown always say, right, it's not over until I win. It's not over until you win. All right, so that's my secrets for a successful business. Part 1 and part 2. This is the second part of it. So if you like this video, please comment down below. Subscribe to my channel. Comment. I'd love to hear from you. I'd like to share more things with you. Let me know what you want me to share more on. Take care. See you. Bye.